Hello everyone, my name is Kevin Keller. I've been a certified music judge since 1998 and have held a variety of positions of contest and judging leadership over the years. From the very beginning of our society, contests have driven the evolution of the barbershop style. We hear and see innovations that we like and we attempt to imitate and learn from it. Yet, often throughout our history, the rules have dictated what is regarded as barbershop. As a result, part of the evolution of style is driven by what is rewarded. The recent Legacy Quartet Championship, wasn't that spectacular, showcased some of our very best quartets throughout the last 50 plus years. As you watched it, were you wondering why the groups did certain things and then later groups didn't? These patterns were driven by the rules. Like any endeavor, if you want to win, you discover what is being rewarded by the judges. Around 6 to 7 years ago, I was attempting to do some research on the history of a particular rule we were discussing. I contacted Harmony Hall for help. I was told that no archives of contest and judging existed beyond whatever we had in our possession. So after having a heart attack at the thought of losing all of the history of contest and judging, I sent out requests throughout the land to obtain as much contest and judging history as possible before these documents found their way into landfills, rules, meeting minutes, letters, etc. And the members came through. I'm 100% confident we do not have all the materials, but we now have a very strong archive system for contest and judging. Almost all of what we have has been digitized and stored in our society's digital archives. So as I was going through this process, it became a dream of mine to write a book to document the history of our contest and judging history and how it influenced the barbershop style. There are so many myths about judging that at one point in time were likely true, but no longer true. Some rules were in place and now are gone. Why did that happen? We look at some decisions today with decades of experience and we think, what were they thinking? But at that time, the smartest barbershoppers in the world felt it was the best solution to the problem they were facing. So one would think that with a pandemic, one would have more time than normal to write this book. Alas, the book has not written itself. However, this summer I've made a couple of different hour-long presentations on the history, and a new vision appeared. We could do a documentary series walking through every era of judging, diving deeper into some of the rules, some of the lore, and how it's impacted us. That we could do. Currently, I've broken up this history into 11 segments, but that is subject to change. The presentations for the first two videos are completed, and the third one is almost done. Those three will take us from 1939 to 1961. Each video will be 1 hour or less. They will be released hopefully every 2 to 3 weeks. It really depends upon my ability to get each one done. The Society will host these videos and some supporting documents that go with each video. In closing, this series is a labor of love for me. As a result, to watch these videos and review the materials will be free. I don't want anyone to not have access to this valuable historic information. So stand by, and we'll start with our first video of the early years in the next week or two.